No, I think I just rested 3 days. I think I'm good. What I'm looking for is... the old man would be in here. Gold ore. Locked it down with a giant chain. Gold ore. South. All right. So we have unlocked new jobs. We've unlocked the Dragoon, the Viking, the Bard, the Evoker, and the Dark Knight. Thing is, there's no gear for any of these classes in this first town, so it's essentially you're still in the Fire Crystal stage of things. Mostly because the Evoker is not available right now. I'm trying to think how I want to do this. Heroes of Amur. Let's do this actually. We'll start by turning Lunith into a Viking. The only one we're not gonna change is Arc right now. Cause I don't want her getting gimped on health all the time. That'll be no fun. Rifia and Ignis, you're gonna become a Dark Knight. Thank you. Murakumo, and then a blood sword is amazing on Dark Knights. Because they can restore the HP they give up. Thing is though, their darkness ability works, does the same damage from the back row. So it's actually smart to keep them in the back. Maybe the crystal shield because you're all about provoking enemies and absorbing damage. Basically an upgrade to the knight. Well, not a straight upgrade to the knight, but... but we do need a harp. We do need a harp. Let's turn this potion into a harp. I need to look up which harps do what really quick. Give me just a second. Okay. What do each of these harps do? Sorry, they don't make this very straightforward. Okay, list of songs. So, Madara will cast Protect on everyone. Minuet casts Haste. Requiem damages enemies. Paeon restores HP. Elegy does. Okay, I think I'm gonna give myself a couple different harps here. So, you will turn into Minuet or Loki harp. Sorry. And then what else we got? Dream harp is very useful. We're not really needing these items anymore. We're kind of evolving past that point in the game. Potion. You can be the Apollo harp. There's really one harp that's not that useful. Loki heart. Now they all do the same damage. You know what? Since we're cheating anyway, let's go ahead and evolve him to Evoker. This is the class that can start doing summoning. I think that which robe you put on will lean his... Okay, so evokers can use low summoning, which is basically each summon has two different attacks, a white magic type and a black magic type, and then high summoning, which is the strongest, the kind you're used to in Final Fantasy games. And which one you equip to changes which effect is more common. So black robe to get more offense out of him. And then we need to start giving him some magic. So we're gonna drop a couple of his spells. Oh, we need to go to a shop. We need to go to an inn in order to change some things up. Here, you can take a look and see what they sell. Well, they sell the first harp, I guess. That first harp gives you protect each turn. Really what you're wanting. There we go. Let's get those magic charges back. Figure out what level of magic you can actually use right now. To level 6, but I think 6, 7, and 8 are all involve quests. Getting those summons all involve quests. And we're gonna do the quest, so we're just gonna drop. We'll remove sleep. Blind. Lazara. And Shade. Drop those ones. And then they give me those as items, right? Yep. Let's turn those into the spells. Okay. So, sleep turns into... Lazara turns into Spark. Turn sight into... Alright. We got Chocobo, Shiva, Rama, Ifrit, and Titan. Okay. Ifrit and Titan are going to be very useful. Titan does damage no matter which version comes out, and Ifrit has very good effects. Shiva and Rama have status effects as their white abilities, so they're not terrible, but not great either. Alright. We're gonna have a cool team. It's gonna be a pretty cool team. Alright. Moving on from our adjustments, let's get back into the game. He says to find the heroes. They should be around here somewhere. Yeah, I think they show up right down here. Oh. Well, they would. Have you met the heroes? Look for a group of old men. They should be around here somewhere. It's four of them. They are very interesting characters. Yeah, ooh, that's us. It's true, it's true. Those old men think they're the four legendary warriors. Are you the four warriors of legend? Oh good, oh good. Tally-ho! Mind the stench. Sewer entrance should be here somewhere. That's right. There we go. Enemies yet, huh? There we go. Let's show off some of the stuff these new classes can do. So, one of the things you can do is provoke. You can make an enemy attack him. Like, focus solely on him. Start showing off some of these summons. Everyone's been hasted. Actually, let's stick the healing one on since I have the Dark Knight. One second, let's get those job levels up, huh? Mm-hmm. You was one hell of a Viking. Alright, their stats should be boosted after this next battle. Right? I better check that. Some of them might have huge. Yeah, they do. Let's get rid of those job adjustment phases. Sorry. I know that's taking a bit. Let's look at our stats here. 38 strength, 51 vitality. 54 intellect, 43 mind. Vitality, 47 mind. 41 agility, 31 strength and vitality. Although... help us! Chocobo kick. Yep, Chocobo's not the greatest. Making a real battle out of these frogs. Oh well, that's settled. These silly fucks. Alright, Ignis. The Blood Sword is not doing so hot damage-wise. We need to be more overwhelming than that. What do we need health for, you know? What we need is... whatever the second strongest Dark Sword is. Obviously the ninja has one that he can use, but... Here we go. Murakumo and Muramasa are the exclusive ones. So what we want is Masamune. Okay, so let's go in here. Turn you into Masamune. There we go. Now I can do some serious damage. Plus that gives him more agility, I am pretty sure. Yes, it does. There we go. Let's go ahead and stick him in the front. Why not? We got the Viking. Let's get it. Boys. We hate status effects, don't we? That's why we're gonna switch to the ribbon. Don't hit back. What the hell is that supposed to mean? We don't need any of that shit. Yeah, who are you and what do you want from old Delilah? Already gone back to town. We only wanted to help you out. We've seen Levy grass shoes before, and those didn't look anything like them. Delilah, these four are the real legendary warriors. Magic. That ain't nothing. I'm gonna take a short break, guys, but I'll be right back. You won't even see it happen. That was lame. Is there a better way for me to say that? I'll be right back. Haha, back in a flash! Haha, back in a flash! And we're back. Alright, so, we need to go south to get to Goldor's Mountain Manor. Rangers! Oh, we got a canoe. I completely forgot we had a canoe. When's the last time we used it? Oh, look! It's a reskin of a boss. Everybody levels up. There, we got over that. Let's do a little savey poo. We're going to do a little transition here, because the thief is once again useful. Yee. The Viking is really useful when you're sailing and when you're fighting aquatic enemies and for being a defensive kind of thing, though I think the knight might be a little bit better at that. Now, thief is of course here for opening doors, and as you can tell, this is like a thieves' paradise. Okay. Everything's gold. Gold bear. I love it. DPS boys, DPS. Is there nothing in here? I thought each of these had something. I may have been wrong. Maybe the gold bears are worth a lot of money. Yeah, destroy him. I love Dark Knight, that's one of my favorite classes. Alright, okay, my favorite classes are Blue Mage, Red Mage, Dark Knight. I'm trying to round out a top five. Let me think here. Red Mage, Blue Mage, Dark Knight. I always like playing as, like, ranger characters. That's pretty far up there. Dragoon's pretty fun, too. I don't know. I guess I'm not much of a magic user. I like Red Mage, thinking of him as a spell sword kind of thing. There, of course, there's classes that are more specifically like that. But I like the utility of the red. But blue mage is probably my favorite. I just like the idea of, like, just learning from monsters and that kind of stuff. Gold pterodactyls. Gold eagle. Oh man, making the bard attack is not really... Doesn't matter. These two are always gonna attack first. The bard will always act first if it swings. Always. So weird. Oh, here we go. This is the real treasure. Somewhere back here. There is... I know there's a bunch of treasure chests somewhere in this room. Oh wait, I'm going the wrong way. Damn it. I'm definitely going the wrong way. Second. Doing all this leveling up with the thief class, which I'm not really... Losing out on some HP here, I'm guessing. Ooh, gold knights. This is the room you go to last. I was mistaken. I think we go through the main entrance, and then there's a locked door we can use. Right. I know there's a big treasure trove somewhere around here. Look at this Joker. Like, this tacky. This guy's gotta be Persian. We'll be right back. There we go. Golden sword. These are terrible because if you've ever tried to kill someone with gold, you know it's not a very good metal for a sharp weapon. But they sell really well. Which is cool. And wyvern claws. Which, if you're still using claws at this point, you're not doing it right. Maybe, okay, there is one point I could see you using claws, and that's if, when we unlock the black belt class, it starts at a low job level, so the damage isn't perfect. You might use claws at the very beginning of that. Now we're ready to move on. Man, I thought the thief would be really useful here, but he doesn't actually open any doors except for the one you need. Like, the other ones don't give you anything. Okay, so let's do the job shift. Back in the saddle. The game gives you at least one magical key, so technically, even if you don't switch to the thief, you would be able to get past that. Vitality is starting to matter a little bit more when we're leveling up, which is why for the end of the game we're gonna all switch all the characters over to black belts for the final leveling to get their HP up as high as possible, because that's the only thing that carries over no matter what class you switch to, is your max HP. It's the only stat that really it matters what you level up with, and I think that changes in 5. I'm not positive, but I'm pretty sure that changes in 5. Oh, here. I'll give you a chance to see Ifrit. Isn't that awesome? Just free healing every turn? automatically at the very beginning of the turn. Yeah, the Evoker isn't the strongest class. You gotta remember the damage isn't split when you're hitting multiple enemies, though. But yeah, those are weaker versions of the summons still. Isn't he fabulous looking? Goldor, you will not take my crystal. Instead, you will take a sound thrashing. Yeah, he's actually a really cool looking enemy. Let's switch over to Loki. Madara gives us Protect. Okay. Let's give him a chance to see what he's gonna do. He's pretty resistant to magic, so I don't think this is going to do much damage. Unless that counts as a physical attack. Oh, protecting himself, huh? Keep provoking. You. Try switching. Equipment. Okay, Loki Harp gives us haste. Makes us hit more, I'm pretty sure, in these version games. Let's try Soul Eater. Yeah, remember, he's got... That should probably do it, man. No! Alright. Let's finish him off. That would do it. Gold armor is resistant to get magic, that's the idea. Stay away. If I can't have the crystal, neither will you. Why you gotta be a jackass? He broke it. Uh-huh.